Hello IP students, today our topic is Python Pandas data frame, and this is Python Pandas data frame part 3. In our previous lecture we discussed about creation of data frame using list, using series and using dictionaries. In this lecture we are going to discuss about some operation performed over data frame. So first operation is column addition. This small program related to column addition. We can add a column in an existing data frame. So first line is import pandas spd. This is essential for execution of the program to Python pandas, because we know that data frame related to Python pandas, and for this purpose we import pandas library here, and pd is alternative name given to pandas. So whenever you want to use pandas as a library, just write pd in place of pandas after the dot sign and after that name of function. In second line there is a declaration of a dictionary in which three argument, one index position, second is, first one is name of column basically. So index position given in dictionary work as a column name, and second one is name of series. Second one is series, and series contain element 1, 2, 3, and third one is index. Index contain element ABC, and after that second one contain elements 2. 2 is the name of column again. PD dot series. So it is a series declared here and contain element 1, 2, 3, 4, and after that index position ABCD. So there is a basically a declaration of a dictionary in which the index position of a dictionary contain basically work as a column name, and if we don't declare index then it is by default 0, and elements are 1, 2, 3. One thing should be remembered, that if there is no element against any index value, then NaN will be appear there, and NaN means not in above. And next line contain pd.dataframe d. So there is a declaration of our data frame using this dictionary mentioned above. And after that, if you want to add a new column, so just write pd.series 10, 20, 30. Actually, it is a column which you want to add in data frame df, and its column name is 3 because it is assigned to df3, and index position are again ABC. And after the execution of the statement, we find out a data frame which contain another column named 3, and after that adding a new column using existing column. So this is a print statement, and in this second last line df4 df1 plus df3. So actually it add two columns 1 and 3, and name of column is now 4. So 4 is a name of column which contain the addition of column, contain the elements which is the addition of column 1 and 3. After that there is a small print statement here, and let us see its output. It is an output adding a new column by passing a series. So 1, 2, 3, there are 3 columns here, and let us see a program in which we add a column name 3. That's why 3 will be appear here, and for the index value d there is no value in column name 1 and 3. That's why NaN will appear here, and when we add a column 4 which is a combination of 1 and 3, then after the execution of int df statement, this is the output, column name 4 will be appear here, which is a combination of column name 1 and 3. And again, if there is not a number or not a value against these index position d, then NaN will appear here. So this is the output of the program. Next is column deletion. If you want to delete a column, then there are two possible ways to do it, and these are use del function or use pop function. So both are same. you can use both of them, but the syntax is little bit different. Here is it is a small program. Import pandas as pd. Again, pandas is the name of library. Pd is alternative name of pandas. Second, there is again a series containing column name 1, 2, 3 and data items 1, 2, 3. In second data item 1, 2, 3, 4 and third one 10, 20, 30. Index position are A, B, C and D. If there is no value against an index position, then NaN will be appear definitely. Then DF is equal to PD data frame D. There is a print statement after that, and data frame will be printed. Till now, there is only a declaration of a data frame. So after that, delete operation is there. We use del df1 to use del operation, del function. First of all, write del, after that some space, and then name of data frame, which is df in this case, and in bracket just write name of column which you want to delete, and name of column is 1 marked within a single quote because it is a string. And after that print statement, to use pop operation, just write name of data frame first, which is df in this case, after that pop, pop operation, pop function, and in parenthesis name of column, which is 2 in this case. So after the execution of that statement, deletion of column 2 will be done. So as far as the difference is concerned between delete and pop operation, notice that in delete operation we first of all write del, after that data frame, and in bracket we write name of column. But while in pop operation, name first write name of data frame, after that pop, and in parenthesis we write name of column. So this is a little bit different between delete and pop. As far as functionality is concerned, both of them perform same function, means deletion of column. So here it is the output. After deletion of 1 using delete function, output look like this. This is original, and this after delete operation column name 1 is no, and after pop operation, since we delete 2 and 1 is already deleted, so that's why there is only one column name 3. So this is the output of the following program code mention. Next is row selection, addition and deletion. So if you want to select particular row or some rows, then there is a method used for this row selection, as well as we can add addition, and we can perform addition and deletion. So let us take one by one. Selection by labels. So first of all row selection. Row can be selected using two ways: selection by label. Here there is a small program again. Import pandas as pd d. There is a small data frame here, and this data frame is created using a dictionary. 1 and 2 are the name of columns, and it contain elements 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3, 4 row wise, and index position are ABC and ABCD. If there is no element against an index position, then NaN will appear there. And to select by label, just write the function LOC, location. So in this line we write print df. Df is the name of data frame, after the dot sign and after the LOC, and in bracket name of index position, and in this case index position is B. That's why it is marked in a single quote, because it is a character. So output look like this. So this is the output. These rows are selected. Next is selecting by integer location. We can also select by integer location. It is similar to that of the previous one, but there is a small difference between these two, and the function name is iloc. So it is a selection by integer location, rest things are same. And in this we mention integer location 2, and by which we can get this output. So this is the selection procedure. So for selection, LOC and ILOC are the two methods, two functions used for selection. Next is slice a row. So we can cut a row or more than one rows using slicing. So this is a small program here. Import pandas as pd. Pandas is again a name of library. Pd is alternative name given to pandas. And whenever you want to use pandas as a library, just write pd in place of pandas after that dot sign and after that name of function. So here is there is a dictionary, and this dictionary is passed as a parameter in data frame. So a data frame will be created using this dictionary. 1 and 2 are the name of columns. 1 2 3 1 2 3 4 are the data elements, and index position are ABC and ABCD. Here we used slice. So using slice, there is 2 2 4. This is slice. So as we know that index position start from 0, so first represent row. So 0 1 2 and 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the rows, and for columns, it again start from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So after the execution of this slicing actually we discussed only in our previous lecture. This is in NumPy. In NumPy, it is already discussed. So as far as slicing is concerned, the concept is same as that of the previous, as that we discussed in NumPy. So after so slicing, you get this result 2 4. Next is addition of rows. For addition of rows, we use function, and name of function is append. So there is a again declaration of data frame, and if you want to add a data frame to another data frame, df1 and df2 are the two data frames, and if we want to add these two data frames, then just use append function. And append function is df is equal to df append df2. So df2, which is a database, is added to a data frame df. So after execution of that statement, output look like this. Both data frame will be added. DF and DF2 are two data frames. Next is deletion of rows. For deletion, we use the function drop. So again, there is a declaration of data frame here, and before drop we print a statement here, and after drop we print a statement here. Actually, we drop here drop 0, so 0 index position will be deleted here. This is the output. This row is deleted. 0 contain elements 1 and 2, and after deletion this will be no more. Again, get the maximum value of column in Python pandas. If you want to find out the maximum value is in Python, then there is a small program here. Create pandas as pd, create numpy as np. Here there are two libraries used. First one is pandas and second one is numpy. And first of all, we create a data frame here using dictionary, and name of columns are name, and value against these columns are Elisa, Bobby, Janvi, Arab, Raghu and Zubair. And second column name contain elements 26, 24, 23, 22, 23, and 24, and the name of column is age. And third column name is score, contain elements 85, 63, 55, 74, 31, and 77. Using this dictionary, we create a data frame here, and we pass name of columns here, again name, age, and score. By default, name of columns are name, age, and score. So if we don't pass these as a column name, then it doesn't make much effect in this data frame. And after that, there is a print statement of data frame. So after the execution of that statement, data frame will be printed. Now if we find out the maximum value of all columns in a data frame, then we use function max. So max function is used to find out the maximum value. This is an important point. So df.max is assigned to variable a1, and after that there is a print statement which print a1. And if we want to find out the maximum value of column wise, suppose for column age, then we just write df and in bracket give the name of column, and name of column is age. So df age dot max. And for similarly for name column, we just write df name dot max here. And if you want to find out minimum value, so there is a function name minimum. So min function is used for this purpose. And for column wise, if you want to find minimum value, just write column name with the data frame as df age dot min and df name dot min, and after that print statement which will print the desired result. So this is the output. This is the actual data frame here. This is the actual data frame, and name of columns are name, age, and score. These are the index values, and index values are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and these are the data values. Elisa 26, 85, Bobby 24, 63, Janvi 23, 55. Now main task is to find out the maximum minimum value along column wise. So first one is get the maximum value for all the columns. So if you want to find out the maximum value of all the columns, then name is Zubair, age is 26, and score is 85. Now here one thing is very important. When you find out the maximum value in case of name, which is a string, then answer is Zubair, because Zubair name starts from Z. That's why it is the last letter of English alphabet. That's why it is a maximum value. As far as name, age, and score are concerned, there is no confusion, I think, at all, because 26 is the highest value corresponding to age, and as far as score is concerned, highest value is 85. But if we want to find out the maximum value against each column, then we use the column name with data frame, and that is again the answer, which is same as that of the previous one, in which case we find out the maximum value for all columns. To find out the maximum value against each column, this is the output here. Similarly for minimum, again this is the output. Minimum value for name is Ara, because name starts from double A, so that's why it is the minimum value. Actually another name, Alicia, is also start with A, but the second alphabet of Arab is A and second alphabet of Alicia is L. That's why Arab is the smallest value throughout this column. And minimum age is 22 and score is 31. And if you want to find out the minimum value of column age, it is 22, and minimum value of column it is 31. Now, there is a small program regarding mean median mode, and we can calculate mean median mode in our data frame. But first of all, what is mean, what is median, and what is mode? So there is a small numerical here to find out the mean median mode. Mean means average value. So there are some values, and these are 13, 18, 13, 14, 13, 16, 14, 21, 13. These are actually 9 values. So to find out the mean, first of all, add these values, and after that divide it by 9, because total number of values are 9. Find out we got a value which is 15 in this case, and 15 is the mean. So to calculate a mean, it is very simple. Just add all numbers and divide it by total number of numbers. We got mean. Means we can also say that average. So now second term is median. Median is actually the middle value. If we find out median, first of all, write all values in ascending order. Write all values in ascending order, and just write the middle value. Whatever be the middle value, it is the median of that data set. So there are 9 values, and middle value is of the fifth number, and fifth number contain 14. So that's why 14 is the median. Formula for this is total number of values plus 1 divided by 2. So in this case, we can easily find out median. Second one is mode. Actually, mode is a number that is repeated more often and other. So 13 is the mode. So a number which appear more than one times, and actually in this case there are many numbers which appear more than one times, and a number which is appear largest number of times is called the mode of that particular data set. And in this case, mode is mode is 13. In this case, largest value in the list is 21 and the smallest value is 30. And there is another calculation of range. To find out the range, range is largest minus smallest, means 21 minus 30, so 8. It is the range, and mode is again 30, because 13 is appear 4 times. 14 appears 2 times, 16 appear 1 times, and 18 and 21 are 1 time each. So that's why mode. So this is a small. This is the concept of mean, median, mode. Again, mean is the average of numbers or a particular data set. Median is the middle value of a data set, and mode is the mode the value which appear largest number of times. Now, there is a small program related to mean, median, mode. In this program, there is a calculation of mean, median, mode using Python data frame. So first line is import pandas as pd. Import is a keyword, as again a keyword. Pandas is the name of library. Pd is the alternative name given to pandas library. Whenever we want to use pandas as a library, just write pd in place of pandas. After that, put dot operator, and after that, name of function. We import pandas here because we want to perform operation over data frame. So second line, there is a declaration of data frame. So just write pd. Pd is the name of alternative name of pandas, then after dot sign, and name of function in this case is data frame. And there is a data frame contain value 10 20 30 40. First set, second set contain value 7 14 21 28, third 55 15 8 12, next 15 14 1 and 8, 7 1 1 8, and 5 4 9 2. Columns name are apple, orange, banana, and pearl. And index values are basket 1, basket 2, basket 3, and basket 4, basket 5, and basket 6. After that, there is a small print statement. Data frame is. So it will be printed as it is. Data frame is printed as it is, as given in within double quotes. After that, there is a print statement df. So data frame will be printed. Next, there is again a print statement. Calculate mean. Slash n sign is there, which means next line. So there is a gap of a line after that, after this statement, before df there is a line which will print calculate mean, and then df mean. Now it is important to calculate mean value, just write name of data frame. In this case, name of data frame is mean, name of data frame is df, and we write df dot mean. So df dot mean, mean is the name of function. So using this function we can find out the mean. Similarly, df dot median, median is the name of function belongs to data frame df, by which we can find out the median. And to find out mode, we just try df dot mode. So name of functions are mean, median, mode. For calculate mean, median and mode, so it is very simple. Now this is the output here. This is the output. Data frame is contain the elements column name apple, orange, banana and pear, and row name or index value are basket 1, basket 2, basket 3, basket 4, basket 5 and basket 6. So value corresponding to column name apple are 10, 7, 15, 55, 15, 7 and 5. Corresponding to orange are 20, 14, 15, 14, 1 and 4. Corresponding to bananas 13, 21, 8, 1, 1 and 9. And for pear, it is 40, 28, 12, 8, 8 and 2. And if you want to find out the mean, median, mode, for apple mean is 16.5, for orange mean is 11.33, for banana it is 11.66, little bit similar to as it of orange, and then pear it is 16.333. So these are the mean values of different column apple, orange, banana and pear. You can calculate by taking average of these, using these number. For example, if you want to sum 10, 7, 55, 15, 7 and 5, and after that addition divide it by 6, then you can find out the mean value of apple, which is 16.5. Similarly, you can find out the value of orange, banana and pear. In this case, actually it is calculated by mean function. So this is the answer: 16.5, 11.33, 11.66 and 16.33. these are the answer for mean value corresponding to apple, orange, banana and pear. Next is calculate median. To find out the median, we use the function median, and again median is calculated for different columns, and different columns are the apple, orange, banana and pear, and value corresponding to these are corresponding to these columns are 8.5, 14.0, 8.5 and 10.0. as we know that median is the middle value, median is the middle value, so these are the middle values. And then calculate mode. Mode is the is a number which is appear more than one times, or the largest number of appearance number is called the mode. So mode in case of apple is 7, orange is for 14 and banana 1 and pear 8. So these are the mode belongs to different columns apple, orange, banana and pear. So it is very simple to find out the mean, median, mode of a particular data frame. Just use the function mean, median, mode, and before this write name of data frame. In this case data frame name is df, after that put dot operator, and after that use median out function. So there is a calculation of column wise, we can get mean, median and mode. So these are the basic operations performed over data frame. In our next lecture, we performed some more operations regarding to the data frame. I hope you like this video. Till then, goodbye.